have started the lesson separation of substances in the previous class. Okay, so in previous class we also discussed about different methods of separation, such as hand picking method, threshing method, winnowing method, as well as sieving method. Okay, so in order to separate the grains out of the impurities. So now let us discuss about few more methods of separation. So in the previous class I have already discussed about sedimentation and decantation concepts. Okay, so let me recall this concept once again in a very short term, and let's go for the next process, that is filtration. Okay, so what is sedimentation? So if the two components are together combined and form a mixture, at that time if the heavy component of a mixture settles at the bottom, so such process is called sedimentation. Whereas the method after the sedimentation is over, when the heavy component of mixture is settled at the bottom, the lighter components are in the top portion. Okay, so those lighter component is nothing but it may be, usually it is liquid. So that liquid means water, along with the impurities, lighter impurities, they are removed through this process, that is known as sediment decantation. So the water along with the impurities are removed, such a process is called decantation. So then what is filtration? See here, so suppose you have a tea, you have prepared a tea by using a tea powder, sugar and all, so you wanted to drink it. So but what happens here, so tea powder mixed with that, at that time you cannot do its sedimentation and decantation. So if you do decantation also, still tea powder remains with the tea. So at that time you have to use a strainer to separate the tea powder from the tea in another cup. So the impurities are separated through a strainer. Okay, you have to either use a strainer or cloth, cotton cloth you can use, which are having the pores, and like glass you can even use the filter paper. So by using these three materials you can filter the in unwanted impurities through the pores, unwanted things remain on the top and pure substance goes through the that given substance. So this method is called filtration. Okay, so in today's class let me explain you what is exactly the sedimentation, decantation and filtration. These three processes together I am going to explain you through a lab activity. So let's move towards the lab and let us check how this process works. Yes dear students, now I am at the lab. Yes, here I am having some instruments with me. Okay, so here there are four beakers, right, and I have a stand here. So with that I am also having a funnel. Okay, so with that I have a filter paper. Yes, so now let us go for the all three activities, sedimentation, decantation and filtration. So here in the first beaker, what I have done is I have taken a beaker. Okay, so for that I have added a some quantity of what, soil. Okay, so you might be knowing, especially after the rains, the water get mixed with the soil and it becomes muddy, and even the water which comes from in the tap, that also sometimes mix with the soil particles and it become muddy, and even the water supplied through the ponds and rivers that we obtain in our taps, that is also muddy water. So then do you think that all the water we get from the sources of water and the taps is pure water or a safe water? No. So in such case, what simple method we can follow is, we have to just tie a cloth for the tap so that we can get the filtered water. Okay, little safe than the previous one. So here, how can we filter the water? Okay, so what are the different methods can we use to separate the insoluble impurities out of pure water, you know, this muddy water, to get the pure water. So here some methods I am going to explain you. Firstly, we have to learn about the sedimentation. Yes. Here I have taken a beaker. You can directly take the muddy water from the river or pond, or directly what I have done here, I have taken a beaker and I have added amount of some maximum amount of water, and for that I have added a soil particles. Okay, so after adding the soil particles to this water, so it becomes a muddy water. So you have to keep it for minimum 20 minutes to half an hour. Okay, I kept it for half an hour because it takes time to settle. Yes, now what happened here, the soil particles, all heavier components of a mixture, so here it's a mixture of water as well as soil. Okay, so the soil being a heavier component, it got settled at the bottom. Yes, you can look at it here, the soil particles got settled at the bottom of the beaker. Yes, now the remaining lighter impurities, yes,
lighter impurity is water, it remains on the top layer. Yes, now this process is called sedimentation. I explained you. The heavier container components of a mixture, if they are settled at the bottom, this method is called sedimentation. So here the sedimentation has taken place. Now what you need to do is, you have to slowly tilt this beaker and pass the lighter water, I mean that water into another beaker without disturbing the water. Okay, you have to transfer without disturbing the impurities which are settled at the bottom. Yes, let me slowly tilt the beaker and transfer it to another beaker without disturbing. Yes. Okay. Now the water that we have obtained here, now in the second beaker, this is decanted water. So this process is called decantation. Means what happened here? The water with the top layer of water with the impurities, it is removed, transferred to another beaker. Okay, second beaker. So this is decanted water. Now can you just observe here? Compared to the first beaker, this is a purely muddy water. Look at the second beaker. It's almost around 50%, it is a 50 to 70%, it's a clear water. Okay, now if I transfer this water into another beaker by using a strainer, okay, so here the strainer is not available. So if we use the strainer and if you transfer this water again to another beaker with the help of strainer, still we get some amount of pure water. Okay, by using the strainer, that is the second method. Okay, so now what I do, after filtering through a strainer, but still the water is muddy or brown in color, little brown color you can see, it's a muddy water still. So now what I do, I take a cotton cloth here. Yes, here there is a cotton cloth which is having the pores in it, okay, which are having the small pores between the woven threads. Okay, there are many threads that you have studied about the lesson, fiber to fabric, where the fibers are, cotton fibers are woven. Okay, there are small holes are there, or they throw that. So through that water I am going to transfer into third beaker here. Let us look at it here. So it's a beaker having a cloth, cotton cloth. So I am going to transfer this second beaker water, decanted water, into third beaker. Look at it here. Yes, slowly I am transferring this decanted water into, from second beaker to third beaker, which is having the cloth. Yes, I explained you already. So filtration process can be done by using a strainer. First one strainer, second one is cloth. Yes, now you just check it out here. Yes, the water you obtained here, it is around 70 to 80%, it's clear water. So do you still find it muddy? Yes, around 10 to 15% there is a muddy water here. Even after passing the water through a cloth, cotton cloth, still the water is filtered now. Through the small pores, the water is passed. So remaining, you see, you can look at here. In the cloth, some soil particles are remained, impurities are remained on the cloth. So now what I do? So this is the third step. Now finally, let us go for the last step of filtration process. That is filtration through the what? Filter paper. So this cotton cloth has a small pores. Okay, they are having the small pores. Now the filter paper, so here I have a filter paper. Okay, so this paper, filter paper, has a still thinner fine pores than the cotton cloth. So here only the very fine water particles can pass through, the all the impurities can be remained on the top portion of this. So how to make this filter paper? See, what you need to do, you cannot directly put the filter paper here. Okay, so first what you need to do, so I will tell you how to make the filter paper into cone shape. You have to convert into cone shape. So first you have to fold in this manner. Yes, in the middle you have to fold and it will become a half. Now again fold it in the middle. Yes, yes. Now, so what you need to do here? Yes, so you have to open like this. So it came in the form of cone. Yes, can you see here? It is in the form of cone. So same thing I have already formed here and kept it in the filter paper. Yes, now let's remove this one and we'll keep, not a problem. Yes. Okay, so here I have a beaker, funnel, so which is fixed to a stand. So now I am going to fix this filter paper into a funnel, right? Yes. Now, what I am going to do? I am going to keep one empty beaker here below this, right? It is fixed. Now I am going to pour this water which is filtered through the cloth into this. Slowly it is passing through the filter paper. Slowly it is getting filtered. Yes, you can observe carefully here. The water is filtered through the filter paper. So little by little you have to go on adding the water as it is getting filtered through the filter paper. All the fine water passes through the filter paper and all the unwanted impurities like soil, dust particles, they remain on the top portion of the filter paper here. Here you can see. Yes, the water is passing through the cone, this funnel, in which the filter paper is fixed onto the funnel in the form of cone. Yes, you can observe here carefully. Yes. All the water is transferred to the last beaker with help of filter paper. Yes. You can observe this carefully. So this is how you can form the cone shaped filter paper, right? Yes. The process is going to be end. Yes. The water is almost every amount of water is transferred through the filter paper and we got a pure water over here. Yes. Now the filtration is completed, right? So now just observe here, look at the first beaker and look at the last beaker. Yes. Have you got the pure water out of muddy water? Yes. So this activity shows you that we can get the pure water from the muddy water by using the sedimentation, decantation and finally filtration through the strainer, cloth as well as filter paper. So I hope, dear children, you have understood this concept and you can perform even this activity when you come back to the school. Let me show you, demonstrate once again. Okay, so note down the definitions and study well. Thank you and have a nice day.